Good morning students of class 10. Today we will complete chapter number 1, Economics, Revenue Portion. The chapter is Development. Already we know that what is development. Development means in one side economic development, in another side other development of the life, like education, like prosperity and the health condition, proper housing, sanitation, drinking water and other factors. Now come to today's topic. Today's is body mass index, BMI. BMI is calculated in the weight and divided by height square. Weight should be in kilogram. This BMI is used for measuring the persons by which we can understand that person is malnourished or undernourished. That means it is helpful for the body structure of a person, and it is helpful for to understand the person is undernourished or not. Or that's why it is estimating undernourished. Now look, next one, Human Development Index, which is prepared by UNDP. United Nations Development Program project. So in this project, it is calculated for the whole world, and on three factors it is calculated. First one, life expectancy at birth. Life expectancy at birth means what? The average age of life. Average age of life is, if it is increasing, that means the standard of living is increasing. If we see the average expectancy at birth in the time of independence, we can see it is 45 or below 45, but now it is nearby 67. That means the people live average the 66 to 67 years. Next one, gross enrollment ratio. Gross enrollment ratio or gross enrollment rate. That means the children who are coming to primary school or secondary school or colleges and universities, they are combinedly called what? Gross enrollment ratio, because education is also a factor for development. We will later discuss on this sort of topic. Next one, per capita income. Per capita income means the income of the persons, or total income of the country, that is divided into population, divided by population, and then we can understand the per capita income. And per capita income is the indicator of the economic development of any country. So these three factors, calculates the condition of one country. In 2011, if we see the India's condition, India was in rank of 134. In the same way, in every year it is calculated and the data has been changed. Now come to the education. What is the importance of education? We already told that gross enrollment ratio. Here we can see the condition of education. Education makes man more perfect, or the behavioral changes of the person, then skill or manpower, then person is having modernized attitude and personality development, then to promote the science and technology. So education makes a man more perfect or more skillful to do anything confidently. That's why importance of education is here. Now come to another one, public facilities. Public facilities means those facilities which are provided by the government for the development of life of the people. As for example, public libraries and hospitals, schools, children, playgrounds and other facilities like drinking water, sanitation, housing. These also given by the government. Even we know that beside income, there is need of security and safe environment, pollution free environment for working. That's why beside income we look after the another factors which is important before joining a job. Now come to here, the national income. National income is used on the basis of that country's resources, how the resources are used, as for example coal, mineral oil, natural gas, and another thing is production. Production is also an important factor for the national income. And another is the service sector. We know that primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector, that combinedly give the feedback for the national income. Even those things which are exported by India or any country, that is also helped to increase our national income, which we can say the earning from export. Next comes to the public distribution system. In public distribution system means what? The government provides some essential commodities like wheat, rice, sugar, kerosene, and another facilities like the pulses also nowadays. And these are the essential items or essential food products which is needed for the survival or for the benefits of the people. If you see, the Tamil Nadu is successfully imposed. To impose this public distribution system. Anyway, today the whole country is facing the problem of pandemic, COVID-19. And in this situation, those people who are jobless now, they are also given support by the public distribution system. So the government provides this public distribution system to the people for the supply of essential commodities, essential goods items, which help to increase the standard of living of the people. Now come to here, sustainable development. Sustainable development means what? In one side we can say maintaining the quality of life, both present and the future generation, without damaging natural resources or environment. So without polluting the environment, if we go for the development, that is called what? Sustainable development. We cannot stop development, but we should go for the development with sustainability. That's why sustainable development is important. Rio de Janeiro summit, you have read in geography first chapter. This summit also helped to develop this concept, the sustainable development. Because we cannot stop development, but the development should not be compromised with the needs of future generations. That's why sustainable development is important. Last one, human development. The main purpose of this chapter is what? The human development. Human development means, in one side, we already said that economic development, in another side, the another needs and desires for the life. So, political development, social development, economic development combinedly make the person develop or human development. So this is the ultimate of this chapter. We will read this chapter carefully. Thank you.